Journalist Gretchen Carlson is now speaking out. She wrote an op-ed for the New York Times talking about being silenced after suing the head of Fox News, Roger Ailes, for sexual harassment. In 2016, she signed a non-disclosure agreement, meaning she could not talk about her experiences while working at Fox News. And in return, she walked away with a hefty sum of money. But she points out that signing such documents does not protect the victim. She writes, "Had I known my complaint would help ignite such a profound cultural shift and that I would be depicted on screen, I would have also fought against signing that non-disclosure agreement. At the time, I just wanted to bring closure to an ugly chapter in my life. I want my voice back." Nicole Kidman portrays Gretchen in the upcoming movie Bombshell about the scandal. So, Jeff, not only is she saying that NDAs are inherently predatory, but she's also asking for them, in so many words, to be illegal, at least when it comes to victims of sexual harassment and sexual assault. Not right. So much protecting your property if you invented a business idea.
Right. And even in, you know, a lot of people don't know, but this, you sign NDAs for everything in Hollywood. You know, when you're trying out for a show or something, or if you're hosting a new concept, you have to sign those, and you can't talk about
someone's
that.
Property, so to speak.
Absolutely, absolutely. So as far as it goes for like victims of sexual assault or something, I think it's their option if they want to sign or not. If they want that payout, like Gretchen Carlson did, she got paid a lot of money to sign that NDA. Had she known that a movie would come out explaining her story and she could have capitalized on it that way and had a voice that way, she might not have signed. But people settle all the time for these NDAs. I know it's not maybe the answer everyone wants, but they're getting financial compensation for signing that. Otherwise, they don't have to sign it. It's up to them.
Go ahead, Lindsay.
Well, she initially said she signed because she knew that she would still be open to speak about harassment. She didn't know that a movie and TV shows would be made about her life. So now she feels like her likeness is being taken from her, and she can't do anything about it. And I know that NBC, in this instance, when they had harassment settlements, they got rid of all those NDAs. And so Fox, maybe in order for their reputation, should follow suit in order to say that we're a company that wants to be on the right side of history here. I know it's business, but, you know, just be dealing with the sexual
business.
Harassment.
I see this as someone being pushed into a corner because, as Gretchen Carlson pointed out, Tori, the majority of these survivors end up being fired from their professions and almost blackballed to a certain extent. So if you're supposed to make, let's say Gretchen Carlson's making $2 million a year for the next 30 years, that payout's not going to be comparable. And then you don't even have the confidence to get back into your career because no one's going to let you in. That door is closed.
Yeah. Do I think non-disclosures are predatory for sexual harassment and sexual abuse victims? Yes. But I also think it's a contract and you walk in with open eyes. What you just
you
said
don't
is...
don't walk in with open eyes. You don't.
You know that
you
if
have
you're
no
getting
choice.
This,
you're being
you do
fired.
Have a choice. You don't have to sign
That's
it.
That's not true. In many of these cases, they are if they're not fired blatantly, they are being weeded out. They're transferred to different departments. Their hours get dwindled.
But Gretchen
and
Carlson
so what they,
didn't have to sign that. Now, she would have lost out on $20 million.
She also would have been blackballed. According to her, she would have never worked again in that industry.
But that's a choice you make for $20 million.
But it's not a choice.
It is a choice.
How is that a choice if you're being told, Tori, if you're being told you're not going to work ever again?
Mm-hmm.
So you can go talk, you can do what you want, but you're not going to work ever again. How are you supposed to secure any sort of finance to protect your livelihood for your children knowing that you're never going to work again?
Well, here's the thing. If her lawyers were thoughtful and thought maybe there would be a movie about me or someone taking my likeness, they should have thought about that way too long ago. This contract was in perpetuity, meaning forever. That is a crazy contract to sign. I agree with you. But she had a choice and lawyers to look through that contract and make choices or make
you think it's a choice that's based on
yes,
survival.
It's predatory. Yes, and I think for sexual
and so
assault,
how is that
I get
a choice,
it.
Though, when there's so much gray
no
area
one's holding
surrounding
a gun to her
it.
Head to
of course, no
it.
One's holding a gun to her head, but we have to face the facts that when you know you're never going to work again and you've got children and you've got a livelihood.
But she is working
who
again.
Said
her book
she's never
going
to work
right.
again.
The majority, according to statistics, the majority of survivors that come out of these situations are blackballed from their job and they no longer work in that profession. So is Matt Lauer. I mean, that's different because we don't see him as a victim, but that's a bad analogy.
I just think it's frustrating when you're fighting the good fight. I look at Colin Kaepernick and I was appreciating everything he was doing, but once he signed that non-disclosure and agreed to the deal with the NFL, he can no longer speak about the topic anymore. And so it kind of frustrates me. It's like, do you want to win the short game or the long game?
But we're also blaming the victim, in my opinion. We're not rectifying the situation by saying, okay, this NDA is predatory. Instead, we're saying, well, you shouldn't have signed it, when in reality, you're just trying to, A, finally be done with that toxic situation to secure some sort of income for your family, knowing you're not going to work at Fox News for the rest of your life?
Then let's say if she wants to talk in the NDA, does she give some of that money back? Because in a contractual obligation, it's got to be a tit for tat. It has to be. That's how contracts work.
I see it as and I know you see it as predatory too, but I only see it as predatory.
I hear you. It's a good point.
Yeah, it's a great conversation. Yeah. I'm glad that we're having it.